Welcome to episode 54 of Diecast TV Channel.
In this episode, Cobra discusses some Matchbox finds and purchases he made this week, and ends by opening one. While in the toy store, Falcon notices an interesting error and has a super surprise. My eagle eye spots more treasure on the pegs. And lastly, Cobra visits a couple of shops on the lookout for vintage Hot Wheels.
School holiday sales are around the corner, but the Hot Wheels pegs at most stores are fairly static at the moment with a lot of older stock out. But whenever that happens, I find it's a good opportunity to look at the Matchbox pegs. As you can see in this photo, they had the newer wave of Matchbox models in this store. They also had this Airport Ground Crew 5-pack that I hadn't seen before. Is it just me, or does that white express delivery van look like the Hot Wheels Speedy delivery van? While looking through the Matchbox pegs, I found this old car. It's a Hero City S-Cargo, a play on the French word escargot meaning snail. It's a fun model, but not realistic enough for my collection. Then I spotted this wheel paint error on a Desert Endurance Baja Bullet. Clearly the paint was meant for the wheels and not the tyres. In the end, it was two of the newer models that came home with me. Another of the MBX Mountain Holden Ute SSVs, which I'm hoping to use as a custom when I get time. And a sweet MBX National Park Land Rover Discovery. Now the Land Rover Discovery has a split blister, which can only mean one thing. Okay, we're going to have to crack this open. Awesome green paint there, like a British racing green. But it's actually from the National Park series. Little spare tire on the back. What a fantastic casting. Over to you, Falcon.
This week we went to a toy store called Toy World on the hunt for new models. From experience, they usually only refill their stands every 2 to 3 months, so it could be a long time between new cases. They also tend to remove all the green stripes before they reach the pegs. So while it was a surprise to find a completely full stand of new Q-case cars, it was no surprise to see no green stripes in there. But what we did find were two cool things. The first was a couple of Mars Rover Curiosities. But the curiosity was really that in the blister, they're facing in different directions. It's not a flipper because there's no room in the blister for that. But which one is the error? We think the top one in the photo, with the white camera and laser mask closest to the yellow stripe, is correct, as this is the front end of a rover. And the one at the bottom is the packing error. The second item just goes to show that hidden supers work in the collector's favour, because I found this guy sitting behind two other cars. It's an HW Main Street 12 Dodge Charger RT. Here's the regular and super versions beside one another for comparison. I have gave this one to Eagle to help him with his 2012 Hidden Super Collection. Speaking of Eagle and treasure.
Hi guys, Cobra and I had a great Sunday evening. Cobra had been working all day and needed a break, so he and I went out to the warehouse to see if they had any new stock. When we walked in there was a family with 3 young kids looking at the pegs, and the father appeared to be going through each car on the pegs looking at the stripes. So Cobra and I went to a nearby aisle and filled in 5 minutes looking at the Lego while we waited for them to finish. When we went back to the Hot Wheels aisle, the family had gone, but there was another older guy now looking at the pegs. Again we went for a walk to the other end of the store to fill in time. When we came back, the coast was clear. At first glance, it looked like there was just old stock sitting there, but suddenly a DW1 jumped out at me. It was right in front of my chest on the end of a peg, with some old Hot ones behind it. Cobra and I were about to go when Cobra noticed something out of place down on the bottom left peg. Crouching down, he noticed the shiny wheels and red stripes on the bonnet. Whoa! That's a hidden Super 69 Camaro hiding behind that little monster jam. What a great find, and we're amazed how those treasures stayed undiscovered like that despite all the other customers' interest.
And I'm back to quickly show you what I found at a couple of shops I went to out of town on the weekend on the search for vintage Hot Wheels. At the first shop, which was a fairly dated stationery shop, they had this very old Matchbox 0G set with sun-faded packaging hanging on a peg at the rear of the store. Copyrighted in 1994, this set's 18 years old. The second shop was an antique shop, and inside it was a fairly confined space with every bit of horizontal area, including furniture tops, filled with bric-a-brac. I was the only customer with two staff looking on, so sadly I could only get this one sneaky camera shot. These die-cast cars were on the bottom shelf of a locked cabinet. Most were in play-worn condition, and they all looked to be fairly average models, nothing exciting like red lines or real rider tyres here. The little sign inside says, "Box cars $45 each, others all $25 each." I personally can't see how any of the castings pictured justify such high prices, but at least I know what to expect in future when I'm looking for vintage Hot Wheels. That's it for episode 54 of DCTV Channel. Thank you to all of our channel viewers and subscribers for watching. Before we go, I have a treat especially designed for our super friend, MrSenCTVT. It's a beautiful Volkswagen Karmann Ghia. As I was taking these photos, the owner actually walked up and we started chatting about his pride and joy. He mentioned that post-World War II, Volkswagen had decided to build a luxury line of cars to go alongside its popular Beetle range, and that to achieve this, they outsourced the manufacture to German coach building company, Karmann, and they in turn hired an Italian design firm named Ghia to do the design styling, hence Volkswagen Karmann Ghia. It's apparently all original, and he's going to get the bumpers re-chromed in the near future. Have a great week, everyone. All the best from the team of three at DCTV.